Hello and welcome back to the Healthcare and Complicated YouTube channel. Before I proceed, make sure you subscribe to the channel, also acknowledge our partners and all the magnificent past guests. Lots of content, rich content, I should say, there for you. But today gives me great pleasure to introduce Anne Aerts. She is the head of the Novartis Foundation. Anne, how are you?
Hi, João. Nice to see you again. I'm fine. And what about you? It's such a pleasure to be here with you on the YouTube channel.
Brilliant. Thank you so much for accepting my invite. It's also very, very nice to see you. We're talking before the recording that we're keeping busy, moving around, yes, carrying our mission of making an impact in global healthcare, right?
Exactly. Yeah.
It's truly fascinating the work that you are doing. And today we are here to discuss the power of data in transforming global health. And the first question that I have for you is, how can data impact and transform global health?
Well, João, that's a question we can talk a long time about. But if I give the example, for me, no data means no health. We have to use the opportunity of living in this digital and data-driven era to tap into the massive computational power and the big data analytics we have now to better understand what truly drives our health. And we know that data can really impact strongly the health of entire populations. We've seen that throughout our work at the Novartis Foundation, where we pioneered, together with the health authorities in São Paulo, for example, a city of about 15 million people, we work together to improve cardiovascular health of the whole population. And the success of this initiative was thanks to the use of data and digital technology. So the data were the fuel to make everybody see clearly where the gaps in the population health roadmap were. If we saw that we didn't diagnose enough patients as compared to the number of people we would expect in the health system, we would focus on that and go to find the patients in the football stadia or the metro stadia. When we saw that the patients in the system weren't even getting their blood pressure under control, for example, we would work on the adherence and the education of the patients. So data helps the governments and their partners to follow the progress in how well they are doing for the health of the populations they serve. And they can redesign the interventions accordingly.
Brilliant. And thank you so much for sharing this very powerful example. And this leads very nicely to the next question, which is, do you believe the magic combination is the data combined with digital technologies such as artificial intelligence?
Oh, yes, João, you speak to someone who's very passionate about that. Mm-hmm. So the example I just gave you is from our large urban health initiative, Cardio for Cities, that we are now replicating around the world through the Cardio for Cities Accelerator. And it has been rapidly successful thanks to the use of data. But we want to bring this one level further now. And at the Novartis Foundation, we created now the next initiative, which is called AI for Healthy Cities, where we work with data-rich environments such as New York City, Singapore, in Switzerland, here in Lisbon also, where you are. And we are discussing also with Helsinki to bring together the data from the health sector with data from other sectors, those influencing the health of populations, because we know only 20% of our health is driven by the healthcare we access, and the other 80% is driven by the conditions in which you are born, you grow up, and you age. So we have to understand that other 80% much better. And that is the opportunity of data and advanced analytics, bringing those data insights to the decision makers where they should allocate their resources to improve the health of the populations. And AI applications are the thing that every single government is asking us, because you can build a simulator of how much the health impact will be of this intervention as compared to that intervention, or how much the health impact of this policy would be instead of doing that policy. So you help them, you give the authorities a decision support tool driven by AI and the data insights coming out of their own data to make the best choices and have the greatest impact on the health of the largest number of people. So data and AI is the combination to address the huge global health challenges we face nowadays. We have to tap into that opportunity.
Thank you. And certainly a lot of industries, I mean, most industries are looking into data and AI, and certainly the healthcare industry really needs the data. But I like that example that you give, the 20% data, and then the other 80% are other external data points, mm-hmm. such as behavior and also social economics. So many things to consider, that we really need a tool that is artificial intelligence to blend these analytics and give the intelligence that we need.
Yeah.
Moving on, what are the main global health issues right now, and how can we tackle them?
Well, the global health challenges today are really unprecedented, and João, you see, we are facing the constant threat of new emerging diseases if we just lived through the pandemic. But at the same time, we have a huge increase in chronic diseases around the world, with cardiovascular disease, for example, is the leading cause of death everywhere now, with 1 in 3 deaths in the world caused by heart disease, and most of them in low and middle income settings. And on top of that, 75 to 80% of those deaths are preventable and even are happening in a premature age, in people before the age of 60. So we have to change, to totally transform the way we address cardiovascular disease. Next to that huge burden, we still have an unfinished agenda of infectious diseases, as you see that even the tropical diseases are coming to our more moderate climates now with the climate change. And then lastly, you have this enormous shortage of skilled healthcare workers. So there's not enough health professionals around the world. I think the number of missing health professionals today is about 18 million. So we are never going to be able to train enough doctors and nurses to address the needs of entire populations that are growing massively, especially in low and middle income settings, but also aging very rapidly. We need to do things very differently. And that's the main challenges we have today, but there are many. Yeah,
yeah, thank you for highlighting those. And we're coming to the end of the interview. It's been fascinating. I love talking to you. And also, as you mentioned on the very first question, we probably could do 1 hour on each question instead of this short interview. It's so much to talk about, which is great in a way. I know you are very passionate about your work. I think you also know that I'm passionate about my work and bringing people together and discussing these very important topics, you know, because, of course, society is moving in such a way so fast with technology, innovation, but also these problems are also growing and scaling, you know. I mean, we talk we always talk about scaling technologies, scaling companies, scale up and innovation, but these problems also are growing, as you all know, and you experience that on the ground around the world. And it's been fascinating. I have one last little question for you, which I expect a short answer. This is the surprise question related to the channel. How can we make healthcare uncomplicated?
Uncomplicated.
Yes.
Well, we have to get clarity on these answers. What are the main drivers within the health system performance and within the social economic conditions in which we live that influence our health? And then we can address those. Then we can use the digital technologies, because there's many of them, to address those gaps in our health. So I think that would make it much less complicated than it is nowadays.
Brilliant. Fantastic. And thank you so much. Well, congratulations on your great work. But thank you for accepting my invite and for being in here and talking about such important things.
It was a true pleasure. Thank you so much, João. Ciao, ciao.
Thank you. I'm going to round up now. To all our viewers and listeners, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Also, follow Anne's work on the Novartis Foundation. I'm going to post it. The Twitter and the socials, LinkedIn, connect with her, ask her about her exciting projects around the world, and I'll see you all next time.
Bye-bye.